This is a tutorial video on Figma component and auto layout. This is a simplified wireframe for a post in a social media. On the top, we have a square that represents the image of the post, and at the bottom, we have the username and the caption for the post. There are many posts in a social media app, so this is what many designers do to create that visualization for multiple posts. That is, group this entire section, then copy the group, paste the group multiple times, then edit it one by one to create that look. This works for a simple wireframe because there's not so much edit that you need to make. However, if you are working for a high fidelity prototype for a large scale project, this will take too much time. Assuming you want to reduce the size for the caption font, you will have to do it one by one for each post. And if there's 100 post components in this design file, you will need to do it 100 times. That is why you should use auto layout and components. These two functions often work together, and that's why I put both of them in this tutorial video. Creating a component helps you to create a structure that can be reused. To do that, select the component that you want to create, right-click, and then select Create Component. You should see a purple four dots icon showing up on the top left. Now we'll call this one the main component. To create a sub-component, simply copy this component and paste it somewhere else. Now, if you make an edit to the main component, for example, if we change the caption font back to 15, then this change will also reflect in the sub-component. Let's try to make the corner rounded. Here, if I change the main component, the corner will also be rounded in the sub-component. But there could be issues. If you didn't design your main component right, then there's not much things you could do with the sub-component. Here, I want to change the caption to something that's very long. And I face an issue because I cannot really resize the text box. That is because the text box is set in a way in the main component and you can't do much in the sub-component here. That is when auto layout comes in handy. If we apply the right set of auto layout to the main component, then all components will adapt to the right size and spacing no matter how we change the content. Now I'm going to rewind and let's start from building the right main component. When you are building the main component, please include all the necessary elements, because it's going to be difficult if you want to add element to the main component later on. So for now, I will also add a profile picture here. And since caption could be very long, I'm also going to replace the caption text and resize it so that the width is fitting the image. Now, auto layout cannot be applied to just random elements. So if I select all these, the auto layout button will not show up on the right side because these elements are not placed in a frame. But there are two exceptions. The first one is when you are choosing multiple elements that share the same spacing. The second exception is when you are only selecting two elements. Here we can see the auto layout button and let's click plus. Figma will create a frame for these two elements. And you can adjust the spacing and the alignment by the right side panel. We'll explain that later. Now, you can also use an auto layout within another auto layout. Here, I'm creating another layer of auto layout so that the top section automatically aligns with the bottom section. Once an element is in an auto layout frame, its size will automatically change when you adjust it. Here, I deleted a few lines, and the height of the entire auto layout frame also shrank. Now, I will add another auto layout to align the picture and everything below the picture. Here, if I reduce the size of the image, the spacing between the image and everything below the image will still remain the same. With this set of auto layout, nothing will break if someone decides to make the profile picture bigger or to replace the text in the content. So I will create a component with this large frame. Select the large frame, right-click, and select Create Component. The four dots purple icon will show up on the top left, and there are two ways to use this main component. One way is to go to the Assets page on the top left, and then find the component, drag it to where you want to place it. Another way is to simply copy the main component and then paste it to where you want to place it. One thing that I will also do is to clearly label where is the main component. You don't want to mix the main component into the sub-component, because sometimes you might make a mistake where you wanted to edit a sub-component, but it happens to be the main component and everything changed, and you don't know that. Some designers will also group all the main components into one side of the page and separate that side of the page to the main design, which is on the right side here. Now let's say I want to design a screen that shows multiple social media posts. Auto layout will also help here. First, select the two posts, then adjust the vertical spacing to what you like it to be, then create auto layout. You can also adjust the vertical spacing after creating the auto layout here by this field. Now if you want to create the look of multiple posts, just copy one of these, then press Command V or Control V. It'll give you a smooth look with the same spacing. Same thing happens if you want to change any of the content. If I delete some lines here, the spacing will also keep the same. If one day your company decided that all the posts should have a rounded corner, then all you need to do is go to the main component and change the corner to a rounded corner. All the subcomponents will change as well. With one exception though, if you happen to edit that specific aspect in a subcomponent, then that subcomponent will now reflect the change of the main component. For example, here I'm changing the third post back to a sharp corner. This won't influence any other components. But if I decide to adjust the corner again for the main component and change everything to a 5 radius corner, this will now be reflected on the third post because I've already made an over-edit on its corner radius. To fix this, select this subcomponent, right-click, then choose Reset All Changes. This will bring the subcomponent back to the look of the main component. As a recap, if you will be using a chunk of design over and over again, create a component so that future style changes can be easily made across all copies. Now let's talk more about auto layout. Once you set a frame with auto layout, you'll see this panel. So let me run you through every single thing in this panel. Using the arrow can help you to set a frame to vertical direction versus horizontal direction. The second field is where you can change the spacing between the items. This will probably be your most used field. The third field can help you to add a horizontal padding on the left side and the right side of the frame. And similarly, the fourth field can help you to add a vertical spacing on the top and the bottom of the frame. If you click the bottom right icon, then you can adjust the padding one by one, on the left, on the top, anywhere. Now let's take a look at these dots. If you click on any of these, you'll probably notice that nothing is changing. And that is because you didn't manually change the size of your frame. If you happen to change the size of your frame, then these changes will occur in relation to each side of the screen. There are four additional changes that you can make by clicking the three dots. The first one is the spacing mode. If you change the spacing mode from packed into space between, then the space between element will automatically adjust once you change the size of the frame. Here, this will change to auto, and if I make the frame bigger, then the spacing between these elements will automatically adjust. And of course, you can use that grid again to adjust where you want to stick it. There are some other things you can do with auto layout. To demonstrate it, I will create two circles with very strong outside stroke. Then I will set auto layout to these circles. If I click on the three dot, we can see that for the second field, strokes are set to be excluded. It means that the spacing we set will not consider how much space does the stroke takes up. So if we set the spacing to 0, we can see that the two circles are overlapping a little bit. It's mainly because their strokes are overlapping. But if we set strokes to included in layout, then we can see the two circles perfectly stick to each other. Now let's look at the third field, canvas stacking, and it says last on top. I'm going to set the spacing between these circles to negative 30, and then copy and paste so that I add another circle to it. Now we can see that the last circle is appearing on top. But if we change last on top to first on top, then the first one is on top. This could be useful when you are using those profile icons for people who liked your post. There's just one more left, text baseline alignment. To explain this one, I copied an icon from somewhere else and I will also add a text element. Now, if you create auto layout with these two elements, then it will align everything in the center. This is how the alignment changes once I make the font bigger or smaller. Everything still sticks in the center. Now, if I select the frame and then turn on text baseline alignment, it will align the icon with the baseline of the text, which is this blue line. Here, I'm going to change the size of the font again. And you can see that the icon will always be aligned with the baseline of the text. I need to warn you one thing though, this feature does not work well if your icon has extra padding. Here, as you can see, it's not going to align well if the icon has extra padding. And that's all for auto layout. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on all notifications. Thank you so much and see you next time.